Hey everyone, welcome to the second video in my vector multiplication series. Today we're going to be talking about the cross product. More specifically, we're going to start with the intuition, go over how we compute it. I already made a video on the dot product, and the link to that will be in the description and on the screen. The cross product is a way of multiplying two vectors, A cross B. This will return a vector C. This is unlike the dot product. If you remember the dot product, we would take A dot B, and it would give us a scalar. Right, so instead of a vector, it gave us a scalar. The cross product gives us a vector. This vector is perpendicular to both A and B. So if you imagine A and B as defining a plane, the normal vector of this plane would be the cross product. So how do we tell which direction it's pointing in? Because obviously, there are two different directions that a normal could be. So to find out which direction A cross B points in, we use the left-hand rule. If we have our vector A here, and your vector B on your index, the direction that your thumb naturally points in will be the direction of A cross B. Notice that this gives us anti-commutativity. Usually, when you multiply two numbers, we would say that A times B is equal to B times A. But with the cross product, this is not necessarily true. And in fact, when you have A cross B, this is equal to negative B cross A. And that should hopefully make sense, because if we do B cross A, then you would switch your middle finger with your index and your index with your middle finger, and then your thumb would be pointing in the opposite direction. Your thumb would be pointing down. Next, I want to talk about the magnitude of the cross product. If you remember, the dot product was a measure of how in line two vectors are, the cross product cares about how perpendicular they are. And this should make intuitive sense, because if two vectors are in line with each other, which direction does the normal point in? So it's like the dot product, but instead we want it to be zero when the vectors are in line and at a maximum when they're perpendicular. So naturally, the cross product of two vectors is proportional to the sine of the angle between them. So the magnitude of A cross B is equal to the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the sine of the angle between them. If you want an intuitive understanding for this, this is the equation for the area of a parallelogram. So if we have our two vectors A and B, the parallelogram that they define, the cross product gives us the magnitude of this parallelogram. So now that we know which direction and which magnitude a vector will be pointing in, we're going to work it out for each of the basis vectors. That is I hat, J hat, and K hat. So we're going to have our A vector here, and our B vector here. And then each of these spaces in the middle, we're going to fill with A cross B. And we can do this referring to the directions of our unit vectors. First and foremost, let's work along the diagonal. So, I cross I is obviously going to be giving us 0, because the angle between I hat and itself is 0, sine of 0 is 0. The same logic applies for J hat and K hat. Now, I cross J, if we, you know, fit our left-hand rule to fit this shape, it's obvious that we're going to get K hat. And now, I hat cross K hat is actually going to give us minus j, because it's going to be magnitude 1 and pointing in the other direction. And then the last of this upper triangle here is j cross k is going to give us I. To fill in this lower triangle, we're going to use the anti-commutativity property. Here we have j cross I. Well, we know that that's actually just negative I cross j. So we know that this answer is going to be negative k hat. So k cross j is going to be negative j cross k, negative I hat. And then, of course, j hat. Now we know how the cross product works between any two basis vectors. So if we write any general vector, A, we can write this as, you know, some A1 times I hat, plus A2 times j hat, and A3 times k hat. We can also do the same for any vector B. Now, if we want to work out A cross B, so if we want to work out A cross B, this is essentially A cross B. Now, we want our multiplication to be distributive in general. That means that we can take A1 I hat, cross it with B1 I hat, then cross it with B2 J, and then cross it with B3 K, and then repeat this process for each of the pairs of the components of the vectors. If we do that, we can then simplify it, so we know that our A1i times B1i is going to cancel out, because i-hat cross i-hat is 0. Do that for each of the pairs, simplify, and then we're going to end up with this formula. So this tells us how to get each component of the cross product from our components of A and B. Working with this is quite cumbersome, right? There's a lot of things to memorize. So instead, we can pack it nicely in a determinant. So what exactly do I mean by that? We have our basis vectors, I, J, and K, and then we're going to write A1, A2, A3, and then in the last row, we're going to write B1, B2, and B3. So how exactly does this work? Well, we're going to start with I hat, and this is going to be a plus. So then we concentrate on this part and we do A2 times B3 minus A3 times B2. And that is our I hat. Then we can take J and we're going to slap a minus sign in front of it. And then we're going to be working with these two columns, and we're going to do A1 times B3 minus A3 times B1. And then remember, this is minus J hat. And lastly, we're going to be taking positive K and then multiplying it by A1 B2 minus A2 B1. Now, if we add each of these together, remember that we have the minus sign in here, so we're going to flip this around in reality. This is going to be giving us our A cross B. And it's a more visual way to think about it. Instead of thinking about isolating co-matrices, some people like to think about covering up the column of the basis vector that you're looking at. So you would think about getting rid of this A3 and B3, and then you only need to focus on A1 B2 minus A2 B1. This is incredibly confusing and it's a lot harder to work with than the dot product is, but you will eventually get the hang of it if you practice it enough. So we're going to work through an example. We're going to be calculating the vector 1, 2, 6. We're going to be taking the cross with the vector 2, 4, and 8. So the first thing we want to do is set up this determinant. So we obviously have I, J, and K. Our first vector has components 1, 2, 6, and our second has 2, 4, 8. To calculate the I hat coefficient, we're going to want to take I hat, and we're multiplying it by 2 times 8 minus 6 times 4. For J hat, we need to remember that it's a minus J, and we're going to be multiplying this by 1 times 8 minus 6 times 2. And lastly, for K hat, we're going to be doing 1 times 4 minus 2 times 2. Now, we can simplify this. 2 times 8 is 16, and we'll be subtracting 24, which gives us negative 8 times I hat. 1 times 8, 8, and 6 times 2 is 12. This is going to give us negative 4, but remember we've got a minus sign out here. We need to bring the minus sign in. Negative 4 becomes a positive 4 times J hat. And lastly, our K hat component is 1 times 4, 4, minus 2 times 2, which is 4. So our K hat component is 0. So we don't really need to write anything down, but you know, for the sake of writing it, we will. And this is how we calculate our cross product. The number one most common error when calculating a cross product is forgetting about this minus sign with a j. Please, please, please do not forget about the minus sign. If you have any questions or spotted any mistakes, feel free to leave a comment. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. I've got loads of videos on my channel and loads more coming, so be sure to subscribe to check them out. Lastly, I want to thank the 20% of you that has enabled notifications on this channel. If you don't know what that is, basically, once you've subscribed to a channel, you can also click the little bell, and then that will just give you a notification anytime I upload, and 20% of you have already done that without me even ever asking, which is really cool. So if you want to talk to me any more about this, or even talk to anybody else, we've got a Discord server. The link to it is in the comment section and in the description. Thanks for watching.